As I said, L3, by proof of construction, systematically debunks all of the myths I detailed in the previous slide. The first myth is the border crossing myth, that is, the user space to kernel space switching. Now, L3 accomplishes this border crossing in 123 processor cycles, and this includes the TLB misses that may be incurred because of the fact that we are going from user space to kernel space, as well as cache misses that may be incurred because we are starting to execute some code in the microkernel. All of that put together, L3 shows by proof of construction that you can do that border crossing in 123 processor cycles. And L3 goes one step further. It actually counts through a back of the envelope calculation what will be the minimum cost involved in doing this border crossing. Or in other words, how many cycles will the instructions that are needed in order to do this border crossing take on a particular processor architecture. And they count the number of processor cycles, and they show that the number of processor cycles needed is about 107. And L3 microkernel accomplishes that in 123 processor cycles. Or in other words, this is debunking the myth that border crossing is going to be expensive in microkernel-based design. It's as close to what it would take minimally in the processor, even if you hand code through machine instructions, what needs to happen to go from the user space to the kernel space. So that is proof that microkernel-based design is not going to be incurring any more overhead for border crossing. It turns out that CMU's MARC operating system on the same hardware takes 900 cycles as opposed to the 123 cycles taken by L3 for border crossing. Spin and exokernel that we have looked at in fairly great detail used MARC as the basis for decrying microkernel-based design, saying that, well, border crossing in microkernel-based design is expensive because it takes this much time. But what L3 has shown is that it need not take this much time. It can be done in much shorter amount of time, which is close to what the hardware can actually do.